Hello friends, a very good morning to all of you. So let's begin today's current affairs. But before that, if you have not subscribed to our channel till now, then do subscribe and hit the bell notification so that you do not miss out on the important updates. You can also join this Telegram group where we provide you with free quizzes as well as we try to resolve your queries. So if you want to directly connect with your mentors, then you can just click on the link in the description below to get enrolled in this group. Okay. And this is the new course for 2022. So let me give you a brief about this course. We have PDFs, videos and mock tests in this course. Along with all these features, you will also get preparation strategies, preparation tips for your interviews. So we conduct mock interviews as well so that you can be prepared for your interviews also. Apart from this, in this new course, you will get this book kit that will include all these books. And right now we are running a 30% discount on this course and the coupon code is RBI30. That you can use to avail this 30% discount. If you have any queries, then you can just call us on this number and get it resolved. Okay, so let's begin the questions. The first question is, with which company has Ministry of Tribal Affairs signed an MOU for digital transformation of tribal schools such as Eklavya Model Residential School and Ashram Schools? So we have IBM, Intel, Adobe, Microsoft and Apple in the options, out of which the right answer is option B, that is Microsoft. So under this MOU, basically training will be provided to the teachers as well as students in the artificial intelligence and new technologies to equip the students as well as teachers with the new technologies. Now guys, under this MOU 250, Eklavya Model Schools, Model Residential Schools have been selected, and out of these 250, 50 Eklavya schools will be given rigorous training, and it is expected to train at least 500 teachers in the first phase. So that is all that has been revealed about this MOU, and that is all that you need to know. Now my question from you is that since when Eklavya Model Residential School scheme was implemented? You have to tell me the year. Moving on to the next question. Who among the following has become the first Indian woman to summit Mount Pumori? Baljeet Kaur, Gunbala Sharma, Neetu Pathak, both A and B, both B and C. The right answer is option D. So recently, Baljeet Kaur and Gunbala Sharma, these two have become the first Indian women to summit this Mount Pumori. So let me tell you that this mountain is a part of Everest Massif. So this Everest Massif is a group of mountains, and these mountains are, first is Nyuktse, second is Lhotse, third is Everest, Mount Everest, and fourth is this Mount Pumori. So all these mountains are in this range of Everest Massif, which is in Nepal. Now guys, that was all about this question that you should remember, that it is Baljeet Kaur and Gunbala Sharma. Now these two people were not alone, they were accompanied by Sherpas from Nepal also. Now you should also remember their names who accompanied these two women to Mount Pumori. So the names of those two Sherpas are Nuri and Gelu. So these two Sherpas accompanied Baljeet and Gunbala on the Pumori mountain. And remember, it ranges, this mountain is in Nepal. Okay, next question. Which company has launched world's first private digital court? So, IntelliLabs, Hyperverge, Nikki.ai, Jupitus, Artivetic.ai. So, out of these five options, the answer is option D. Jupitus Justice Technologies is the full name of the startup that has launched the world's first private digital court. Now, guys, this world's first private digital court aims to serve the purpose of arbitration and mediation. So basically it is alternative dispute resolution mechanism, and through that mechanism or through this digital court, basically the basic purpose of this digital court is to resolve the disputes in a speedy manner, in a cost effective manner, as well as in a manner that can satisfy both the parties. So basically it strives to achieve the settlement between both the parties. So that is the purpose of this first private digital court. Basically, it is providing a platform so that the aggrieved parties can come together and settle and argue for their settlement, or they, in a more formal manner, we can say they can negotiate their terms of settlement through this digital court. So that is the purpose of this court. This is providing the platform for the aggrieved parties so that they can come together and negotiate. So that is the whole purpose of this world's first digital court that has been launched by this Jupitus Justice Technologies start. In which state is Vaidya Aapke Dwar scheme launched by Department of Ayush to provide free medical consultation through video call? Uttarakhand, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu are in the options. Out of these, the right answer is option B, that is Madhya Pradesh. So in Madhya Pradesh, Vaidya Aapke Dwar scheme has been launched. Vaidya refers to doctors. Aapke Dwar refers to at your doorstep. So basically, through this scheme, the medical services, medical consultation will be provided to each and every citizen of Madhya Pradesh by the medium of video call. So this is basically a telemedicine kind of a thing that will be provided through this video Aapke Dwar scheme that has been launched by Department of Ayush. So that is the whole purpose of this scheme. There is nothing much that we can add to this scheme. Next, in which state has Ayush department launched Ayush Ghar Dwar for COVID-19 patients? Guys, I picked up these two schemes because there is a possibility that you might get confused in the examination about these two schemes. First is Ayush Ghar Dwar and second is Vaidya Aapke Dwar. So these two schemes are clearly launched by two different states and the purposes are also different. Vaidya Aapke Dwar is for providing the medical consultations to the citizens at their doorstep. This Ayush Ghar Dwar is also providing the medical consultations, but this is specifically restricted to the COVID-19 patients. So apart from providing the telemedicines, this under this scheme, basically their mental well-being, their social well-being, all of these dimensions will also be taken care of by the government of Himachal Pradesh. So this scheme has been launched in Himachal Pradesh. So I hope that you can clearly understand the difference between these two schemes. Vaidya Aapke Dwar is Madhya Pradesh and it is for providing telemedicine to the citizens of the state. And Ayush Aapke Dwar is Himachal Pradesh and it is specifically for COVID-19 patients, for providing the medical services to the COVID-19 patients along with taking care of their mental and social well-being. So this is the difference between these two schemes. The next question is, what is the theme of World AIDS Vaccine Day 2021? Ending the HIV/AIDS epidemic, resilience and impact. Communities make the difference. Global solidarity. Right to health. Know your status. So out of these five themes, the right answer is global solidarity. In 2021, the theme is global solidarity. Now, when is this World AIDS Vaccine Day observed? The date is May 18th. So remember the date, that is May 18th. Next, when is the International Museum Day observed? So May 18, 23, 29, 11. So these are the dates. On which date is this day observed? So it is observed on May 18. And the theme of this day is the future of museum : recover and reimagine. So this is the theme. Now guys, this International Museum Day is observed by International Council on Museums. I would like to ask a question from you, and that question is, what is the headquarters, what is the location of this International Council on Museums? You have to tell me in the comment section below. On that note, let's say goodbye to each other. I hope that you have enjoyed the video, and if you have, then do not forget to like this video and share it among your friends. Thank you so much for watching the video.